Hi, my name's Marilu Chiofalo. I'm professor of condensed matter physics at the University of Pisa, and I'm here to share with you one of the most weird ideas in quantum physics. When it is about picturing where a particle is in space, the quantum state of the particle, see the speech by Sabrina Maniscalco, has the mathematical form of a wave, called the wave function, that is associated to the probability of finding the particle in a region of space at given time during a position measurement process. This is what the wave-like behavior of quantum particles or matter waves is meant, envisioning how a particle might be here and there. The wave function shares all the properties of everyday life waves we are used to, like those in an otherwise flat water pool when concentric waves stem from where we throw a pebble, the distance between two adjacent crests being the so-called wavelength. So, though it is just a mathematical object, we can use the wave function to lead our imagination in the amazing world of quantum phenomena whenever we are concerned about where particles are. In beautiful experiments, for example, matter waves interfere, giving enhanced probabilities to locate the particles somewhere than elsewhere, and the matter waves of zillions of quantum particles lock together in what is called a Bose-Einstein condensate, behaving as if it were one single superparticle with a macroscopic wave function. The matter wave's wavelength, named after de Broglie, on the other hand, is related to how much motion the particle has, that is, its momentum. The larger the momentum, the shorter the de Broglie wavelength via the tiniest Planck constant. So that, for example, to a 60 kilo person moving at, say, 1 meter per second, would be associated a ridiculously small wavelength compared with his or her size. In fact, 1 billion times smaller than the size of that person as compared to the estimated size of the known universe. Tiny indeed. By the way, the wavelength-momentum connection reflects also into another whimsy, that position and momentum cannot be measured at the same time with unlimited precision. That is, on the other hand, about Paolo Zanardi's speech.